Good evening. Thank you for watching KX News at 9. I'm Becky Farr. In tonight's top story, as the need for healthcare workers continues to grow during the pandemic, the shortage of nurses has been a major concern, and that's even before the coronavirus. Malik Wilson shows us the impact that low numbers have had and how future frontline workers are eager to help.
Life during the pandemic, working as a medical professional, has been difficult.
Michael Curtis serves as the executive director of the McKenzie County Healthcare Systems in Watford City, and he says working at the hospital at the beginning of the pandemic to now is like night and day.
Initially, people tended to stay home, so there was actually a decline through March, April, and May. Then it started to pick up, and especially in North Dakota toward the end of the summer. And into September, the volume did increase dramatically.
Seeing an overwhelming amount of patients due to the coronavirus, Curtis believes it began exposing weaknesses.
And I don't mean the weaknesses in the staff themselves, I mean the shortage.
To address nursing shortages in early November, Governor Doug Burgum announced that asymptomatic nurses infected with COVID-19 could continue working with COVID patients.
You know, this is something that the CDC has allowed for a period of time.
But Curtis says thankfully his staff hasn't had to go that far, but are still forced to make sacrifices.
We have had staff who have had close contact continue to work wearing N95 masks, which are in and of themselves difficult to work in.
Despite the hardships that most medical facilities are facing, students in the studying nursing field are eager to join those on the frontline forces.
I think I was ready when it hit first. Yeah, I feel the same.
Mackenzie Kempley and Casey Smith are both associate degree nursing students at Williston State College, and having to watch the COVID-19 pandemic play out from the back seat has only pushed them to finish school.
Same. It makes me really grateful for the ones who are working right now. Yeah. And when we're out in clinical, it makes me relieved that we can help them.
We are always eager to bring in new staff, and now more than ever.
Reporting for KX News, Malik Wilson.
Curtis says hopefully the COVID-19 vaccine will help lower staff shortages.